This rule checks for narrow traces on power or ground nets as shown in the slide within the tool. If the trace widths are too narrow, the trace might not be able to handle the current requirements, thus increasing the chances of failure. This rule checks for the parameters min width, which stands for minimum allowable trace width, and min width internal, which stands for minimum allowable trace widths on internal layers. The value for these parameters can be set in the spreadsheet window. The prerequisites show which objects this particular rule can be run on. This rule can only be run on electrical nets that have a constant voltage value, that is, power nets or ground nets. With Hyperlinks DRC, we can create rule groups that can run the same rule on different object lists with different parameter values. In this example, I have created two object lists, one for VCC and analog VCC, and other one for 3.3 volt power net. I have set the minimum allowable trace width to 10 mils for 3.3 volt power net, and for VCC and analog VCC power net, the minimum allowable trace width is 20 mil. Now that we have completed basic DRC setup, let's run the rules and see if there are any violations. Looks like the 3.3 volt net has one violation. Hyperlinks DRC will highlight and zoom on the board where the violation occurred. The net width is 8 mil. This seems like a minor violation, and I am going to change the status of it to approved. For the other rule group, looks like there are some major failures. The trace widths are 4 mils, which is too small for the power nets. The layout engineer needs to go back and fix this error. Therefore, I am changing the status of these errors to be fixed. This rule in Hyperlinks DRC helps engineers avoid and fix power integrity issues quickly.